Hi everyone! One question that I've been getting a lot lately is whether we can push the limits of an 11-speed derailleur and install it on a 12-speed drivetrain. So how good is this design from Shimano? Let's take a closer look. For this test, I'm going to use my 12-speed mixed drivetrain, GX chain and cassette, XTR derailleur. Also, I have an XTR 12-speed shifter. And I'm gonna install this GSXT, so this is medium cage, 11 speed. See what we get. From a shifting standpoint, this is what we're starting with. So absolutely nice and smooth. I have a little bit of play here at the very end of my range. Clutch is disengaged, just so I don't introduce that as a variable. Pretty nice and smooth. I've been using this for about a year, no complaints whatsoever. And the first step in doing this is going to be to remove the chain. Next, disconnect the shifter cable and remove the derailleur. The construction of the two derailleurs is quite different. This 11-speed GS is supposed to work with an 1146 cassette as a maximum. The 12-speed obviously is meant to work with the 1051 Shimano cassette. I detailed these two in separate videos. I'll make sure to include the links. But in a nutshell, the big differences are, one is the offset here of the top jockey. You can see quite a difference between the two. Then you have the length of your cage. You can see how the 12-speed cage is longer. And finally, jockey wheels. The bigger jockey wheels allow you to swallow a bigger cassette without making the cage overly long. The length of housing required is exactly the same. However, the limit screws and the B gap, they are way out of whack. So I have to adjust that first. And here it is. So 11-speed GS, medium cage, making it all the way up to a 50-tooth cassette. This is an Eagle 10-250. Let's take a look at shifting. B gap here is about 5 millimeters, which is what the 11-speed derailleurs usually recommend. So let's give it a try. Harder gears. All right, so I would say that's quite impressive. What do you guys think? However, when I shifted back down to the smallest cogs, I don't know if you've noticed that hesitation right here when I got to the 3 or 4 smallest cogs. That is where a bigger offset derailleur like this one would make a difference, because that offset brings the top jockey in this position a bit closer to your cogs. The other thing is, right here, I don't have that much tension in my derailleur with the amount of chain that I have. If I go to back up to the 50 and shorten the chain by about 2 links, I bet you it will shift a little bit better. All right, so is there a conclusion to be had here after our little test? First of all, it's amazing that this works, and I know many people have used GS derailleurs like this on 1150 cassettes, mostly 11 speed or 10 speed. And I assume that would work a bit better only because you are not really pushing the derailleur at the very end over here. Using this on a hardtail is probably better than trying it on a full suspension bike because of the chain growth. If I am to cut my chain a couple of links here, I might be able to put a bit more tension on the chain when on the smallest cogs. So again, another thing that's probably worth trying. But overall, if you have the money, I think I would recommend just getting the proper 12-speed derailleur. And I have a video giving you all the details about the 1x or 2x 12-speed derailleurs from Shimano. And I don't know if you would save that much installing an 11-speed these days, because from a price perspective, they're coming very close to each other. And that is probably the end of my short video. If you guys have any questions, let me know below. Let me know if you are interested in one of these 11-speed derailleurs with 12-speed cassette, or if you're using this with something like 1150. I would love to hear your experience. If you are to use this with a 12-speed cassette, why would you do that? I would be very curious to find out. Once again, I hope you found this useful. If you did, don't forget to like, subscribe, keep an eye on social media, and until next time, hope to see you folks on the trails. Cheers, guys! Cheers!